PlayStation not showing up at E3 2020. Is it a big deal or nothing burger? Let's talk about it. What's up, people? What's up, people? What's up, people? It's your boy MM2K back again with another video. Do me a huge favor, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, rock those bells for notifications, please, so you know when your boy's dropping these doses. I appreciate all of y'all straight up because y'all know the deal. I am not too proud to ask. Let's get into it. You know what? I was sitting back and thinking, y'all. I have yet to do a one-off video about PlayStation not showing up to E3. Now, I've talked about it on my weekly podcast, the NRO podcast that I do over on Twitch, and I premiere here thereafter on YouTube, but I haven't separated this as a topic of discussion, but we're going to do that today. So, here's the thing. I'm hearing a lot of people talk about, E3 isn't a big deal for Sony because Sony this and Sony that and Sony. And I think because we're talking in that fashion, we're over projecting and shooting past the point here that should be relative to us gamers. Okay. No matter how you slice it, this isn't good. And I'm going to break down why. I don't care what anybody has to say and anybody that has anything else to say in contrast. I mean, your opinions are welcome. And like Z says, you can never be wrong for your opinions, but I think you can be silly for them. You know what I'm saying? And I think this is a silly, discussion that we're having right now, particularly for gamers. Okay. Let's break it down like this. I think even at the business level, though, it's not the greatest, the smartest thing to do. I mean, I get it. They get to save some money, and if they're having some squabbles with the ESA, they get to thumb their nose at the ESA and say, aha, so you need us. I get that. But I think it's bad and it's too risky to try to reach consumers at a console launch in a completely foreign format. Especially after these consumers, 45 million of them, just saw the release of the Xbox Series X, and your ability to, as far as power is concerned, your ability to awe them at this moment is still questionable. You know, I mean, they, even though I've been critical of Microsoft's follow-up steps since then, that still was a big thing that helped put the Xbox brand on the map. And fellow YouTubers, content creators, y'all know what I'm talking about. Come on, let's keep it real. When y'all go to post y'all videos, when y'all go to put in y'all tags, what are the most popular tags? Meaning, what is the most popular thing that people are looking up right now? It's Xbox. It's not PlayStation. You know what I'm saying? I don't care about how many Instagram posts PlayStation got. PlayStation is still a worldwide brand that's top-notch in gaming. But as far as people's current curiosity, what's piquing their interest right now, it's that Xbox Series X. Whether I feel the same way or not, it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? So for you to go to a completely foreign format to introduce your new console that's not going to be in direct contrast to what they have to offer, and your PlayStation, and you're the king of the hill, it kind of gives off an imagery that you're running away from these guys because they do got something great to show. You know what I'm saying? And I it's not a given that it's going to bite them too badly in that regard, but I do think that it's not the best move because it's too risky, particularly for a console launch. That's number one. But business-wise, personally, I'm going to keep it real with you. I don't care. I'm a gamer. Fanfare equates to mind share, and you forgo that without a feasible replacement to the E3 format, okay? If you decide again to just say, you know what, we know you look forward to this, gamer. Perfect. But we're not going to do it this way. We're going to show up to 100 Dunkin' Donuts and 100 Subways and try to go up to a couple of abandoned Toys R Us buildings, show up in a few Kmarts, you know what I'm saying, Sears, and do some talk-throughs, sign some books. That's how we're going to replace. If that's your approach to something that I'm heavily looking forward to as a hardcore gamer, then you know what? It's going to change my mind about you as an entity. Y'all know my background. And for those of you that don't follow my material, here it is real quick. I started off this generation a serious Xbox guy. I did not like the content that they provided. Therefore, I looked at the leadership and I said, you know what? I don't think this leadership is headed in a direction that I find desirable. But I've always had PlayStation in the corner of my eye, even though I wasn't the biggest fan of their stuff. But the way they were talking, I was like, you know what? They're talking to me. Until when? Jim Ryan took over. Once Jim Ryan took over, I started having doubts about them now. You know what I'm saying? Because Jim Ryan just don't get the mind share. And it looks like that he's just concerned about the bottom dollar. We'll see. Don't know. But again, perception is 9/10 of the law. And now I'm looking at them a little funny, being how something as critical as this to mind share, you're looking to forego. And I don't care what people say. Oh, they don't need E3. E3 ain't that big. All of y'all that say that will be tuning into E3. Even though you know that Sony won't be there, you will be tuning into E3. And if Sony was there, I wish I could go into an alternative universe to see what y'all reactions would be if Sony was there. Sony's gonna knock this out. Oh, this is fantastic. So stop the foolishness. Stop the bullcrap, please. Lastly, there's no better way, period, to contrast the products that you have in comparison to your competitors. No better way than to have them on the same stage, okay? Now, in the grand scheme of things, and to bring light to a lot of these arguments that are out here, do you or I, the hardcore gamer, the people listening to videos and watching videos or listening to podcasts such as this, you know what I'm saying, on this channel, do you and I need an E3, or in general, or even to have Sony at E3 to know whether we're going to buy the product or not? No, frankly not. However, I consider myself here on this channel a consumer advocate. So I'm not only looking at you and I, but I'm also looking out for the most vulnerable consumers in these discussions of pro-consumer practices and approaches. Now, what do I mean by that? I mean that I'm looking out for the average purchaser. Okay, the average game buyer, all right? These consumers aren't oozing with money, or they're simply not willing to dedicate a plethora of funds to buying everything in the gaming market. They'll simply just buy one console and a couple of games a year. And there's nothing wrong with that. And as such, there's no better way to showcase your product in heavy contrast to what everybody else has out there than to have it stacked up against that competition's offerings right then, right there. Think about it. Any purchase you make at a basic consumer level, you don't say, oh, I'm going to compare. I got multiple choices. I'm going to compare these multiple things. But let me look at just one today, and then I'll check out the rest weeks or months later. Nobody does that. So even at car shows, for example, different consumer offerings as far as vehicles are sitting right there for you to compare and contrast right there at that moment. This is the most sensible and all-around consumer approach we have currently. Now, before any of you go start saying, well, who cares about them? Who cares? We don't care about them. Like you just said earlier, MM2K, we don't need an E3. Remember this. There's more of them than there are of you and I. They subsidize the more hardcore games you like. Period. You don't get a God of War unless so-and-so is out there on his PlayStation buying that 2K VLC or whatever the hell you call it, or buying that Call of Duty DLC, okay? You don't get a Gears unless so-and-so's out there grinding it up in Fortnite with those V-Bucks, okay? Their contributions, again, because they outweigh us, they help subsidize the more hardcore games that we like, period. Therefore, getting them on board is a must. And though they may not watch E3 Live, they pay close attention to the clips and the analysis done immediately thereafter. Who had the best show? Who had the best offerings for this type of game and that type of play style? And based upon that, decisions can be made more thought out and they can be more comfortably made. No way you slice it. Not having that contract side by side is a disadvantage to those gamers in particular. And frankly, it's just a disappointing development for all of us. I understand the reasoning for them, Sony, but I ain't them. I'm a consumer, not one of their execs, and I'm a gamer. And that's it from your boy MM2K. Let me know what you think about what I had to say in the comment section below, because like I always say, who cares what I think? But if you did like what I had to say, you can catch me on the corner of every boulevard, baby. Check out the links below to follow me. Hey, yo, I do a show with your peoples called Scrampunks. It's on Dirk Griggity's channel, part of the PNTS Network. Had a great show last night. Check it out. Look up hashtag Scrampunks. Also, check out the Broadband Bullets with my homie NextGen720. He also premiered his first show with the homeboy David Jaffe, creator of God of War. It's called When Opposites Collide. Great show. Check that out as well, and check out the Broadband Bullies for the links below. Also, check out the Hard Knock Digital Culture, and check me out on Stadia Dosage. And with that said, keep things in proper perspective, people. We are not the execs. We are the gamers. Who cares what just solely benefits them? We cannot throw us out of the equation. That's it. You all have a wonderful, wonderful gaming day. Peace.